Hey TechnoStuds, there's a few different perspectives on what cybersecurity actually means. So let's fully define what cybersecurity is, some different perspectives there are on what cybersecurity is, and what cybersecurity will mean for this course and what we're going to be talking about through the rest of this course. In this video, we're gonna start out by talking about what cybersecurity is and fully define it. We'll talk about the scope of cybersecurity, and then we're gonna get into who's responsible for actually carrying out cybersecurity, for actually implementing cybersecurity. We're actually first gonna define what security means, which security means free from danger or threat. So whatever organization you're working for, if you're part of the cybersecurity program, what your goal is to make sure that the company or the organization is free from danger or threat. Now let's talk about cyber and what the definition of cyber. Essentially, cyber is something that's either related to computers or related to computer networks. And so it's this digital world that we're talking about here. So now we bring those two words together, cybersecurity, which means cyber, computers and computer networks, security, free from danger or threat. So it's really free from danger or threat to our technology and things that are related to our technology. So if we look at the official definition from CISA, it says cybersecurity is the art of protecting networks, devices, and data from unauthorized access or criminal use, and the practice of ensuring confidentiality, integrity, and availability of information. So depending on who you ask or what resource you're looking at, cybersecurity can actually have some different perspectives. So what is the scope of cybersecurity? Well, technically, if we were to look at this, cyber means computer or computer networks or some sort of technology. So it's security around the technology. But we also have this term information security. There's information that falls outside the cyber world. What happens when we print off a document? It is now in paper form. We throw it into the trash. It has sensitive information on it, and that information gets exposed. So that document falls outside of cybersecurity, but it's still something that we need to be concerned about. There are also terms such as data security and network security. And depending on how you define this, they're all going to look a little different out there. So this model that I'm showing you right here looks different on different sites. I would even argue that there's this aspect of security that there are things that fall outside of information security and cybersecurity and data security. Things like one of the things you want to do is you want to protect everything by making sure you're hiring the right people and doing background checks. And so that was one of the jobs that I had to do, was make sure, turn in reports about are we performing the proper background checks before we're hiring people. So there's things that fall outside this bound of cybersecurity and what cybersecurity is. So what are we going to define it for our course? Well, mainly we're going to be talking about cybersecurity from a technology perspective. So that is the main purpose of this course. But there are other aspects that we're going to be talking about that do occasionally fall outside of that realm of cybersecurity and within information security, or maybe even broader than that. So then we ask the question, who is responsible for cybersecurity or the security of the company? And the simple answer to this is, well, everyone in the company is responsible for playing their role, their part in cybersecurity and making sure that things are secure. And that is a true statement. But the problem with that statement is it doesn't have any kind of accountability from a global perspective. And so we do need somebody to take the lead on cybersecurity to establish the goals and establish, you know, what cybersecurity is going to look like for that company. Now, in many big businesses, that is a department. There is a security department that's in charge of overseeing all of that, and that's a great way that's set up so that way there's checks and balances with everything and that there's no conflict of interest. But many small businesses don't have the resources to throw a department at security, let alone a single person at security. So often what happens is it defaults to the IT people within the company to tackle cybersecurity. Which makes sense. You know, there's a cyber component to it. There is some conflict of interest to it. But often the IT department is responsible for cybersecurity. So if cybersecurity falls to the IT department in smaller companies, which makes a lot of sense, it's something that cyber, it's technology, there is a bit of conflict of interest in it, but if it falls to IT to do that, then they are setting policies and they are organizing all of the security around the technology. But because that there's this need that goes beyond just cybersecurity, there often that also gets put on the IT department to make sure security is set for the whole company outside of even the cybersecurity realm, which is one of the reasons why we're defining cybersecurity for this course as being a little bit more expanded to think about other areas as well. So there you have it. The definition and scope of what cybersecurity is can vary a little bit depending on who you're talking to or what resource you're looking at. But essentially, cybersecurity has to deal with security around the technology. And since it's around technology, in smaller companies, it usually falls to the IT department to create policies and procedures around cybersecurity. And because there are missing gaps in that, and that there are other security concerns that need to be addressed, and there's no security department to address that, a lot of times that gets put under the scope of cybersecurity and for the IT department to manage. So you'd often find, or a lot of times nowadays find, that IT departments are managing things, managing policies and procedures that wouldn't typically or traditionally you would have seen the IT department to manage. So things have changed a little bit.